Hello friends, welcome to another episode of Techie Tuesdays. I'm your host and coach, S. Ravi Kumar. Techie Tuesdays is a weekly show where I answer to your tech and career related queries. So if you like my answers, then please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends, family and colleagues. Let's get started with today's questions. Today's first question is asked by Swayanka Bhardwaj. She is asking, how could I get into a front-end developer with no hands-on experience? I'm working in MNC with 2+ years of experience. Which platform should I refer to for learning purposes? Swayanka, you can't get into front-end development without any experience. You need to get some experience as a front-end developer, then only you will be considered for a front-end developer job, whether it is in your company or whether you are planning to change the company. Now let's talk about the platform to choose for learning purposes. It primarily depends on your budget and the time you have. So you need to first choose the time limit that you have, 1 year time or 6 months time to do a course. Then you have to choose that what is your budget and how much time you can devote to learning daily. Also, do you want to go for any certification or not? The better option here would be, of course, to go for any certification. So in my opinion, since you are already experienced, you should do some certification course from platforms like Pluralsight or Udemy or Coursera. So it depends on whichever platform you choose, but go for some kind of certification. Any platform which helps you in getting the certification related to the front-end technology, you should go for that platform. Apart from that, you should also check the ratings of the instructor on that platform. So whatever course you are choosing, see what is the rating of the instructor on the platform, because most of the times the ratings given by the trainees is the best judge. Even in Udemy also, they sort the courses based on the star ratings given by the trainees. So go for the one which has most numbers of stars and go for a certification based training. So in order to transit to a front-end developer role, you need to first complete some course, get a certification, and then probably approach to your senior or approach to anyone, whoever you want to approach for getting a job related to front-end development. Next question is from Harsh Kumar. He is asking, I know basic of programming. What skills do I need to learn to join an IT job that pays 25,000 a month in India without a degree? Harsh, sorry to say this, but you can't get a job in India without a degree, especially in programming, which pays you 25,000 a month. In order to get a job without a degree, you need to prove your skills first. So for that, I would suggest you to start with freelancing and contributing to open source project in the programming language, whichever you know. As you have mentioned that you know the basics of programming, so choose that language, whichever basics you know. Create a profile on any freelancing website like Upwork, freelancer.com or guru.com and apply for the jobs in that programming language. Along with that, also choose a open source project, basically a tool which is written in that language or a product written in that language. Start contributing to that. Look for open issues in that product or tool and start contributing to that. Especially look for the beginner's issues. There are many issues tagged as good for first timers. So look for those issues, try to fix those issues so that you gain some popularity, not along with gaining the skill. So you have some skills, you can showcase your skills by contributing to open source project and then working in freelance. So once you gain some experience and some skills, then only you can apply for the job without a degree. Otherwise, I rarely think that any company will offer you a job without a degree, especially in India. Next question is from Rajesh Nair. He's asking, I recently joined a firm and they are working on old front-end technology. Manager denied for any time to upskill in contradiction to what he agreed before. As other offers are still active, should I leave or carry on? Rajesh, what I am assuming from your question is that you were promised work in a new technology when you are joining this new company, whereas when you joined the company, you got work in the old technology, and now the manager is saying that they won't be upskilling or they won't be migrating the project to a new technology. I don't want to bash anyone particular here, but I see this kind of problem is pretty prevalent in the industry, that many companies at the time of hiring, they promise the candidates that we will give you work in this particular technology. They even take interviews in that particular technology, but when it comes to the work, they give the work in an old technology because that is the work on which the client is working, and clients takes a lot of time to migrate to a new technology because businesses doesn't migrate so easily. They migrate based on profit and loss, and if they are seeing that their current systems are working fine, they just want to maintain those systems. Now let's answer the question that whether you should stay in this company or you should join the company whose offer is still active and I think they have promised you to work in the new technology. So in my opinion, you should first contact some of the team members offline of the new companies whose offer is still active. So if you know that which team you are going to join in that company, or you should talk to someone who is already working in that company and get to know about the project in which you are going to join. So if you know that it is working in the same technology in which you aspire to work, then of course, I would suggest that probably abscond from this company and join that new company. But if you see that it is still working in the same old technology, then I think it won't be a good decision to abscond from this company, as you will be kind of blacklisted in this company. So whatever step you take, do the due diligence first, that whether the new company whose offer is still active is working in the same technology in which you aspire to work or not. Next question is from Dev Malaya Basak. He is asking, I have 10 years of experience in IT. I want to switch to a managerial role from a technical role. Which course and from where should I undergo that should boost my career? Dev Malaya, in my opinion, you need to first check in your company itself that what kind of managerial roles are available and which certifications are required for getting those roles. Many companies have internal programs to upskill their experienced professional to managerial roles. So they provide internal PMP certifications or they provide internal agile certifications. So you need to check into your company policies and talk to your HR first that how you can move to or how you can transition to a managerial role. If you talk about industry standard, in industry there are many kinds of certifications available for migrating to managerial role, be it PMP, be it Agile PMP, be it PRINCE certification. So there are many managerial certifications available in industry, but they of course changed based on company to company. So their importance varies from company to company. So in my opinion, you should talk to senior HR professionals of your company about your transition to a managerial role. Ask them what kind of certification do they need in order to transition to a managerial role and how you can get a managerial role in your company. Next question is from Amit Saxena. He's asking, what job should I choose? Good work-life balance with decent pay or high pay with higher workload? I'm 30 years old and working at American Express currently as a software developer. Amit, in my opinion, you should choose for a good work-life balance with a decent pay, and along with that, you should also try to learn new skills, create your own brand, and try to make multiple sources of income. So instead of going for higher pay with higher workload, get a decent job with a decent good work-life balance where you can spend time with your family. Along with that, you can spend some time on upskilling yourself, getting more knowledge, creating your personal brand, and making multiple sources of income or multiple passive sources of income. So active sources of income are like you are doing some job or you are doing some consulting. passive sources of income are like creating videos or earning from blogs or earning from endorsements. So doing those kind of things. For that, of course, you need to create your personal brand. You are just 30 years old currently, so you still have a lot of time to do that. If you are 30 years old, I am assuming that you already have 5-6 years of experience in the particular technology in which you are working. So in my opinion, you should start writing blogs, you should start creating some training material in your technology and do it on a small pace. So first build your brand by writing some blogs or contributing to open source projects or probably creating videos on the particular technology in which you have experience. So I think in my opinion, you should go for a job with good work-life balance and spend the rest of the time which you have in learning new skills, spending time with your family and creating passive sources of income. Next question is from Himanshu Kansal. He's asking, would companies like Google and Facebook use GitHub as now it got acquired by Microsoft? Himanshu, yes, companies like Facebook and Google are still using GitHub, even though it is acquired by Microsoft. Because GitHub is one of the most popular platform to showcase or to store your open source softwares, with new features coming up almost every day. I can give you an example. For example, React.js framework or React framework is stored, the source code of React framework is stored on GitHub, which is of course managed or maintained by Facebook. Similarly, Google's Angular framework, Dart framework and Flutter framework source code are hosted on GitHub. So yes, Google and Facebook are still using GitHub even though it is being acquired by Microsoft. Next question is asked by Sridhar Mahadev. He is asking, I am currently working as an electrical engineer, 3 years of experience, and want to switch my career to software industry. How do I proceed? Sridhar, are you still working as an electrical engineer or have you lost your job in this pandemic? If you are still working as an electrical engineer, if you already have a job of an electrical engineer, then I think you should stick to it and upgrade yourself in the field of electrical engineering itself to get a better job or a better salary. But if you have lost your job and you are not getting any opportunity in electrical engineering branch, then only you should try to move to software engineering, because right now there is a lot of competition in software engineering field or software development field itself, so that it would be very tough for you to getting job in software industry as a fresher, especially you since you have 3 years of experience. So you won't be getting as much salary as you were getting as an electrical engineer than as a software developer in case of you are trying to join as a fresher. If you still want to come in software industry, then in my opinion, instead of learning something new or some new programming language, you should learn something which is related to your electrical engineering branch. For example, Internet of Things or IoT programming or embedded programming, where you can utilize your expertise of electrical engineering in programming. So that way you will be able to give an edge, or you will get an edge of an electrical engineer experience in your programming side also, and might be you get same package as electrical engineer and probably get a good hike also. So either stick to electrical engineering or learn something which is related to electrical engineering to move to software industry. Next question is from Ahmed Suhail. He is asking, which has more importance for a fresher when applying for a job, an internship certificate or an official programming language certificate? Suhail, frankly speaking, none of these have any importance if you are joining a company as a fresher. So whether you have official programming language certificate or you have internship certificate, you will be still asked the questions which are required for that particular technology, or you will be still need to appear for the test. So none of these will give you much importance even though they might help you in getting a selection for the interview. So let's say if you have internship certificate, so company might select your resume for the interview because you already have industry experience of or internship certificate experience. And if you are getting, like, if you already have a programming language certificate and the company has opening for that particular programming language, like fresher opening for that particular programming language, then they might consider your resume for the interview. So, like, and both of these are equally important in selection of your interview, but it primarily depends on what is the requirement of the company. Otherwise, in my opinion, both of these are like not that much important. The main thing which is important for a fresher to know is whatever they have learned in their college or in their education. So they should know it well. So if you are mentioning that, okay, you have done an internship, or you are mentioning that whether you don't have any certificate, whether you, if you don't have any certificate, be it programming certificate or internship certificate, but you have mentioned in your resume that you know about HTML programming or you know about JavaScript programming. So you should be able to explain what you know, what you have done in a better way. So if you have good communication skills, good logical skills, and if you are eager to learn new things, you will of course get a job as a fresher. But if you don't have any of these skills, then these certificates are not going to help you. Next question is from Rafiq. He's asking, I'm working in HCL Technologies as an associate consultant and having 12 years of experience in Microsoft messaging. What should I do if I want to become an Azure architecture, and where should I start to learn? So Rafiq, by Azure architecture, I think you mean to say you want to become an Azure certified architect. So if you want to become Azure certified solution architect, then in my opinion, there are two websites which are very helpful for that. One is Microsoft Learn website, or docs.microsoft.com. I think both of these are same, and they Microsoft Learn has a proper path, learning path for Azure Solution Architect. So you can learn those courses for free and prepare for your exam and then give the exam for the certification. The second one is Pluralsight. Of course, Pluralsight is paid, but they time to time they give you discounts in their like in their courses. So right now I think they are giving 40% discount in their annual membership. So you can take membership of Pluralsight, and there they have also they also have a complete learning path for getting certified as Azure Solution Architect. So you can choose either of these based on your like your budget and your timelines, and then you can prepare for Azure Solution Architect certification and go for that certification. So these were my answers to your tech and career related queries in this episode of Techie Tuesdays. If you want your questions to be featured in next episode of Techie Tuesdays, you can DM me your questions with hashtag Techie Tuesdays on any social media platform. All my social media handles are Techie Rathore, which you can see here. I hope you like my answers. And if you like my answers, then please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this video with your friends, family, and colleagues. So until my next video, take care. Bye-bye.